When men are not governed by God, they will be ruled by tyrants.
Copying is not theft. Stealing a thing leaves one less left. Copying it makes one thing more. That's what copying's for.
There can be only one.
Please note that the following views and the opinions expressed on this program are not necessarily the views nor the opinions of the Master Force Group, YouTube.com, Free America Radio Network, our sponsors, our partners, and MFG is a private society. Nothing here is ever to be construed as hate, medical, nor legal advice.
Don't attempt anything without the gloves.
And for the international order that we have worked for generations to build. Ordinary men and women are too small-minded to govern their own affairs. That order and progress can only come when individuals surrender their rights to an all-powerful sovereign.
One of these lives has a future. One of them does not.
Whatever goes around eventually comes back to you. So you gotta be careful, baby, and look both ways before you cross my mind.
And now, step inside a memory module.
Two lives. I'm going to be as forthcoming as I can be, Mr. Anderson.
Man shall be ruled by law. God has set before you this day his laws of life and good and death and evil. Not by the will of other men. There is no freedom without the law.
Take it off, it's illegal. Heavens, listen, here's a contest just for you. See if you can wrap your brain around this.
What good is a phone call if you're unable to speak?
Neo is an anagram of one. Here's a salty little film about the metaphors of the root of law.
The system. What kind of feeling does that word evoke in you? Do you think of the system as this super evil, all-pervading, all-powerful behemoth that is constantly scheming and plotting against you? What if I was to tell you that you are the system? That the quote-unquote system is actually a completely unbiased reflection of the ignorance of the average person? That every time a human being is ignorant of his rights and does not stand up for his rights, he creates a vacuum which gets filled by an ignorant power. And that the only way out of this mess is for men and women to stand up in their actual rights and stop being afraid so that that pool of ignorance gets smaller and smaller. You may not like it, but it is the truth.
The definition of a man in Black's Law Dictionary is sea monster, right?
In Old English, it means criminal and sinner. And in the Talmud, it means monster and other things. Okay, yeah. Monster is the prime root because you look at it, it's M-N. And so the M-N you see is the prime root of moon. And so that's where the term son of man comes from because it is seed of the moon. It's all corruption. Seed of the moon. And so with the moon, you get the moon star. That's where we get the word monster from, the moon star. So if you're of the seed of the moon, you're a moon star, you see? And so this is the game. So the word, whether you're like the words you were talking about right now, person, or when you're using the word man, it's the correct terminology is Ashan, A-S-H-A-N, Asha. You know, we see on the map today, it's like right in our face, but nobody tells us what it means. It's spelled wrong with an I. A-I-S-A, right, or something like that, but it's A-S-H-A, and that means royal eyes. We are the royal eyes, and the N at the end of it means that which came down. You see, capital N is a sliding board, and it means that which came down. So we are the Asian, we are the royal eyes. And so if you're using their terminology as the word man, you admit that you're a criminal and a sinner and a monster, and we can include bastard and maybe a few other words, and therefore you're a slave. You've got to use your words, not their words, given to you as your heritage, you know? And so claim it. That's what you got to do, right, with the true star.
True star, the root word of trust.
You, in fact, you know, I remember that a lot of my buddies, they were putting a mini definition log in the back of any of their documents. They would define the words in the back of their documents for anybody who wanted to question their use of terms. You know, that's one of the things they would do. That's why I ended up writing dictionaries, right?
Sure. And go get a copy of Desert's works if you haven't already. The extensive breakdown of ancient text and etymology.
You know, and by the way, I just want to add, you know, like I knew a lady who followed Jack Smith from Right Way Law when I moved to Florida. She was a friend of a friend, and I got to hear her story. And so whenever she was in the courtroom, she was in a legal tussle over an automobile, you know, violation thing. And so she's in the courtroom, and the judge goes, are you Melissa so-and-so? And she'd go, no, I am Melissa so-and-so, you see? And because what he's reading on his paper is the item Sonan, sounds like, looks like, but it's not her. And so she would say, no, that's not me, I am. And she's repeating the same word, sounds, right? But it's not the same spelling, right?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah. So they go back and forth three times, and after three times it was settled. She is not on their paperwork, you know, here in the U.S. in the Styles manual for the United States government, it says anything in a box is not there. And so that would include parentheses. And so, you know, if you put something on a document in parentheses, it's not included, even though somebody can read it, it's not part of the legal ramification of that document. Therefore, it's to expound on something, but it's not included. And therefore, you could use Aishan as your normal parlance, but then you can put right next to Aishan in parentheses, man. You know, so that way nobody can question what does that mean, and they get it. But yet you're not using it, and you're using that which is first, and that which is first is superior.
This is a very special spoon.
Okay.
It was handed down through my family. I'm going in the pawn shop today to try and sell my old silver Paul Revere spoon. My daughter is getting married, and we're putting out for a very expensive wedding. So I obviously need to get as much as I can for this spoon. Well, I'd like to see 15 grand.
Instead, only try to realize the truth. There is no spoon.
Sweet. But there is a big statue of Moloch at the Colosseum in Rome, which of course is a normal fixture and fitting of a church. Not.
There can be only one.
You're alive. Why didn't you die?
Hey, it's a kind of magic.
There is no freedom without the law. There is no freedom without the law.
It's a kind of magic.
Man shall be ruled by law, not by the will of other men.
It seems that you've been living two lives.
God has set before you this day his laws of life and good and death and evil. Not by the will of other men. Not by the will of other men. Other men. Not by the will. other men.
It's a kind of magic.
There is no freedom without the law. There is no freedom.
Not by the will of other men.
There is no freedom.
Not by the will of other men.
It seems that you've been living two lives.
You're alive. Why didn't you die?
Hey, it's a kind of magic.
Woe unto thee, O Israel! You have sinned a great sin in the sight of God. You are not worthy to receive these Ten Commandments.
We've gathered against you, Moses. You take too much upon yourself. We will not live by your commandments. We're free.
Hey, there is no freedom without the law.
Whose law? Yours? Did you carve those tablets to become a prince over us?
Who is on the Lord's side? Let him come to me.
You have cursed us.
Jason and the people made me do it.
Showed you no land flowing with milk and honey. I show you a god of gold. Come with me. Follow me.
Blasphemers, idolaters, for this you shall drink bitter waters. God has set before you this day his laws of life and good and death and evil. Those who will not live by the law shall die by the law.
The Gathering.
If he wins the prize, mortal man would suffer an eternity of darkness.
How do you fight such a savage?
With heart, faith, steel. In the end, there can be only one.
Let my people go!
The slaves are mine. Their lives are mine. All that they own is mine. I do not know your God. Nor will I let Israel go.
Who are you to make their lives bitter in hard bondage? Man shall be ruled by law, not by the will of other men.
Who is this God that I should let your people go?
Aaron, pass down my staff before Pharaoh, that he may see the power of God. In this you shall know that the Lord is God.
Mother! Mother! He turned his staff into a cobra!
Nothing of his will harm you, my son.
The power of your god is a cheap magician's trick. Janus.
Janus.
see?
Moses' serpent swallows up the others.
I've been alive for 4.5 centuries, and I cannot die.
There can be only one!
You're alive. Why didn't you die?
Hey, it's a kind of magic.
How about loneliness?
I'm not lonely. I've got everything I need right here.
Oh, no, you don't. You refuse to let anyone love you.
Love is for poets.
I have something to say! It's better to burn out than to fade away.
To identify the root of law, or to identify anything, we need to know the words we're using and what the letters mean that form them. One of the leading authors of root dictionaries, etymology and the breakdown of ancient text, of course, is the one and only Desert Owl, and he's going to read the Essenes for us and give us his translation for open consideration. The Essenes, the essence, God, does that mean good? Lord, does that mean law? Like the essence of good, you decide. Over to you, Desert.
Elohim spoke all these words, breathing. I am the pure shelter, the law, your great Elohim, the Zulavhain, and have brought you out from the depths of the bondage of darkness. You will have no other law or legislation before me. You will not make unto you any image of the law or pure shelter in the sun above or in the earth beneath. I am the invisible pure shelter, the invisible law, without beginning and without end. So this is the Yahweh, who is the great father. And you will not make unto you any false laws, for I am the law and the whole law of all laws. If you forsake me, you will be visited by disasters from generation upon generation. If you keep my mandates, commandments, I think it's a corruption because they were mandated, it was your choice to follow them or not, but you had to pay the consequences if you didn't follow them. You shall enter in the infinite garden where stands the tree of life in the center of the eternal sea, that you shall not violate the law. The law is, you will not violate the pure shelter. The pure shelter is your Yahweh, who will not hold you guiltless. Honor your earthly mother, that your days may be long upon the land. And now the earthly mother is talking about your body, nature, the animals, everything is your mother, right? Because it's matter. Matter is mother, you know, the cosmic mother that gave you life and form. Spirit from the Father gave you life, but the material creation gave you form. Honor your earthly mother, that your days may be long upon the land. And honor the heavenly the Father who rules from his throne in the sun, that eternal life be yours in the throne of light. For the earth and the stars are given unto you by the pure shelter, which is your great Zulavhain. That's Elohim. Everything is Elohim. Other than the people that are not enlightened, you have to be enlightened to become the Zulavhain or Elohim. You shall greet your earthly mother on the morning of the Shavah, the Sabbath. You shall greet the royal messenger of the earth on the second Morgan. Morning is corruption. Morgan is more of the garden. You will greet the royal messenger of life on the third Morgan. You shall greet the royal messenger of joy on the fourth Morgan. You will greet the royal messenger of the Son of Light on the fifth Morgan, and you will greet the royal messenger of Water on the sixth Morgan. And you shall greet the royal messenger of Air on the seventh Morgan. These are, and there must have been like something they recited, or, you know, that they they did in honoring those different elements within creation. It was not to be worshiping them, but to honor them. That's the difference. All these royal messengers of the earthly mother will you greet. And what is the earth? The earth is an organ, right? It's an organ. It's a big one. The sun is an organ. Everything is Elohim. Everything is breathing. Everything is active, unless it's dead, right? Okay, let me back up here. And you will, and you're the royal messenger. And here it's, you know, I'm using for Malak. Malak means royal messenger. Mothers, the mother's voice. See, in the word Malak itself, you've got Malak, mother's voice. And so everything is speaking, and that's the feminine nature that is speaking for the Father. Every, you know, the message in the stars, the pictures, right? All of creation on earth has makes pictures, tells a story. The serpent, the bird, right? Everything, the plants, all the royal messengers of the earthly mother you will greet and consecrate yourself before them, that you may enter the infinite garden where stands the tree of life. You will pay homage to your Father who rules from his throne in the sun, the great Father, on the evening of the Shabbat. You will commune with the royal messenger of eternal life on the second evening. You see, these are the, this is what I'm reading, by the way, to clarify, is because this is what's on the first 10 commandments. It's a totally different writing. You see, you hear it, right? It's nothing like what you see than what they got, because they couldn't receive the first instructions. You see, they were not qualified for it. They were not ready for it. And so you will commune with the royal messenger of eternal life on the second evening, and you will commune with the royal messenger of work, that's mitzvah, good works, on the third evening. You will commune with the royal messenger of the Eish Shalom, of eternal peace, on the fourth evening, and you will commune with the royal messenger of power on the fifth evening, and you will commune with the royal messenger of love on the sixth evening, and you will commune with the royal messenger of wisdom on the seventh evening. All these royal messengers of the great Father who rules from his throne in the sun will you commune with, and that your soul may bathe in the fountain of pure light and enter into the cosmic sea of eternity. The seventh Dayel, the seventh day, the Chevron of the Eshavat, the Sabbath, you will remember it and keep it pure. The Eshavat, the Sabbath, is the Dayel, the day of the light of the pure shelter, the sunrise, your great Zulavhain, who is the Yavohei, who is the great Zulavhain. They are one. Everything is one. In it you will not do any work, but search the light, the royal domain of the Yavohei, and all things will be given unto you. For know ye that during 6 days you will work with the royal messengers, but on the seventh day you will dwell in the light of your great Yavohei, who is the pure anointed shelter. You will not take the life of any living thing. Life comes only from the Yavohei, who is the great Zulavhain, who gives it and then takes it away. You will not debase love. It is the sacred gift of the great Father who rules from his throne in the sun. You will not trade your soul, the priceless gift of the loving Yavohei, for the riches of the world, which are the seeds sown on stony ground, having no root in themselves and no enduring life, but for a little while. You will not be a false witness of the pure shelter of the law, to use it against your brother. Only the Yavohei, who is the great Zulavhain, knows the beginning and the ending of all things, for his eye is one, and he is the pure shelter. You will not covet your neighbor's possessions. The law gives unto you much greater gifts than earthly possessions, even the earth and the sky, the stars. If you keep the mandates of the Yavohei, who is the great Zulavhain, so all the cosmos is yours and the power within. And Moses heard the voice of the Yavohei, who is the great Zulavhain, and sealed within him the covenant that was between the Yavohei and the seed of light, the children of light, the offspring of light. And the Moleshan turned and went down from the mount, and the two tablets of the law were in his hand of the pure shelter. And the tablets were the work of the Yavohai, and the writing was the writing of the great Zulavhain, graven upon the tablets. And the people did not know what became of Moleshan, Moses, and they gathered themselves together and broke off their golden earrings and made a molten calf. See, it says calf. That's the lie. It's a bull. They made a bull. Of course, they worship the bull. The calf is a lie, but yet the Zionist Talmudic Jews want to call the five books the Torah, right? When it's really a code word for the Talmud, because the five books are called the Pentateuch. That means the five. And gathered themselves together and break off their golden earrings and made a molten calf. And they paid homage unto the idol, the bull, and offered to it burnt offerings. The bull also representing the sun, and the bull also representing creation. And they ate and drank and danced before the golden bull, which they had made. And they abandoned themselves to corruption and blindness before the Yavohai. And it came to pass, as soon as he came near unto the camp, that he saw the calf, and the dancing, and the wickedness of the people. And Moleshan, Moses' anger grew hot, and he cast the tablets out of his hands, and brake them beneath the monument. And it came to pass, or beneath the mountain. And it came to pass on the morrow, that Moleshan, Moses, said unto the people, you have sinned. A great sin, sin meaning having your eyes closed. You have closed your eyes tightly. You have denied the great Zulavhain and the Yavohai, who is the great architect. I will go unto the Yavohai and plead an atonement for your blindness. And Moleshan returned unto the Yavohai, who is the great Zulavhain, and breathed, Yavohai, you have seen the desecration of the pure shelter, for your offspring lost the victory of light, your children lost the victory of light, faith, and paid homage in the darkness, and made for themselves a golden calf. Yavohai, forgive them, for they are blind before your great light. And the Yavohai said unto Moleshan, you must see and read it for yourself. That's behold. You must see and read it for yourself. At the beginning of time is the Kevanun, the covenant that is made between the Yavohai and the Eshan, the royal eyes. That's us. Here it says man, but man is Eshan. That means royal eyes that came down. Eshan, the N, means that which came down. So we are the royal eyes, but we became blind. And the only true anointed flame of the great architect did enter into him. And he was made, let me back up because I interjected here. And the Yavohai said unto Moses, you must see and read it for yourself. At the beginning of time is the Kevanun, the covenant made between the Yavohai and Eshan, the royal eyes that came down. And the only true anointed flame of the great architect which did enter into him. And that's referring to Yeshua, who is the Elohim, or the great Zulavhain, and the Father, for the Father, because the Father is so great, he's beyond the universe and cannot enter in. As it says that if the great Father came into this universe, you could add up all the stars of the cosmos, bring them together, and he would be 10,000 times greater than all the stars of the universe. That's how great he is, how powerful he is, his pure energy. And He obviously, if he made the universe, right? And he was made the son of the Zulavhain, and it was given unto him to guard the inheritance of the firstborn. So Yeshua is the active agent. He is the one. He is all things. He is the only spirit other than we ourselves that are made as royal eyes of creation, and to make fruitful the land of his great father and keep it pure. And he who casts out the Yavohai, the architect and creator, from himself does spit upon his own birthright, and no more grievous blind act does exist in the eyes of the great Zulafane. And the healer, the Yavahe, spoke, breathing, "Only the seed of light can keep the mandates of the pure shelter. Give ear unto me, the mother's eye, for I breathe this way. The tablets which you did break, they will never more be written down in the words of Aishan. As you did return them to the earth and the fire, so shall they live invisible within the hearts of those who are able to follow the pure shelter, the Kevanun, the pure law. To your people of little faith, of victory of light, who did close their eyes against their creator, even while you stood on pure ground before your great Zulafane, I will give another law. And it will be a stern law, yeah. It is one that binds them, for they did not know the royal domain of the light. They could not recognize it. And Moishan hid this invisible law within his breast and kept it as a sign for the seed of light. And the Yavahe gave unto Moses the written law, the pure shelter, the written shelter, the written law. If they obey it, they would protect them for the people. And he went down unto them and spake unto them with a heavy heart. And Moishan said unto the people, these are the mandates, the laws, the legislation which your Yahweh has given you. You will have no other gods before me. You will not make unto you any graven image. You will not take the name of the Yahweh, who is the great soul of Haim, in vain. Remember the Eshavat, the Sabbath Dayel, to keep it pure. Honor your father and your mother. You will not kill. You, and here it's saying shall, and shall means must, so it should really be you shall. You must not kill. You must not commit adultery. You must not steal. You must not bear false witness against your neighbor. You must not covet your neighbor's house, or nor your neighbor's wife, Vefe, nor anything that is your neighbor's, near brother's. And there was a Dayel, a day of great mourning, and atonement for the great blindness against the Creator, which did not end. And the broken tablets of the invisible pure shelter, the law, lived hidden in the breast of Moses until it came to pass in the seed of light. Now it's referring to the Essene in particular. And appeared in the desert. And the royal messengers walked upon the earth. The royal, it's probably not plural, it's probably referring directly to Yeshua. And the royal messenger walked upon the earth. Here it's written way before it happens, but it's present tense. And it was by the bed of a stream that the weary and afflicted came again to seek Yeshua. Like lost seed, they had forgotten the law. Oh, that's it. I just finished it, because the next one is the communions. And another good one. There's two classics in here that were my favorites. And so anyway, you know, I can't help but interject the original thought, Jeff, because these pagan terms are just repulsive to me now after I've been producing these translations and dictionaries.
Sure thing, and thank you so much for doing that, because let's face it, nobody else does. And you can find Desert's works, dictionaries, and channels, Old School YouTube, in the links in description. Thanks so much for reading the Essenes for us today. The essence of good. Good reference for everybody's root of thought. Read for you today by the one and only Desert Owl.
When men are not governed by God, they will be ruled by tyrants. Modern civilization is wrongly directed to the fulfillment of sense gratification, the basis of material life and a barrier to spiritual realization. The demonic believe that the enjoyment of the senses is the ultimate goal of life. However, it is not possible to become peaceful and happy in the attempt to gratify the temporary senses. The result is usually the opposite.
Whatever goes around eventually comes back to you. So you gotta be careful, baby, and look both ways before you cross my mind.
Man shall be ruled by law, not by the will of other men.
There can be only one.
I think I'll miss you most of all.
Don't attempt anything without the gloves.